Shouting to those who celebrate, Hosanna, blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. In that eternal feast may we, in our departed, raise glory to you, to your Father and your Holy Spirit forever.
Thank you. A reading from the letter of Paul to the Philippians.
Glory to the Lord upon the apostles. May the mercy of God descend upon the reader and the listeners, and upon his parents and his children forever.
Paul and Timothy, servants of Christ Jesus, to all the saints in Christ Jesus who are in Philippi, with the bishops and deacons, grace to you, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank my God every time I remember you, constantly praying with joy in every one of my prayers for all of you, because of your sharing in the gospel from the first day until now. I am confident of this, that the one who began a good work among you will bring it to completion by the day of Jesus Christ. It is right for me to think this way about all of you, because you hold me in your heart, for all of you share in God's grace with me, both in my imprisonment and in the defense and confirmation of the gospel. For God is my witness, how I long for all of you with the compassion of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may overflow more and more with knowledge and full insight to help you determine what is best, so that in the day of Christ you may be pure and blameless, having produced the harvest of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ for the glory and praise of God. I want you to know, beloved, that what has happened to me has actually helped to spread the gospel, so that it has become known throughout the whole Imperial Guard and to everyone else that my imprisonment is for Christ.
Praise be to God always.
Sign that the crowd went to meet him. The Pharisees Pharisees then said to one another, "You see, you can do nothing. Look, the world has gone after him." Now among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from the city in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, for giving us his words of life. Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord.
There are a wide variety of views about what is going on here. If we start with the Old Testament and the prophecies, they were aware that among these prophecies, what the Messiah would be humble and would be riding on a donkey's colt. And even though they knew this, this isn't really what they were looking for. They were looking for somebody who would be very powerful, would destroy their enemies, and make them victorious, and restore them to the glorious days in which they were told about in the past. Now, that view is just as up to date today as it was back then. That in so many ways, we want a Messiah that is a great conqueror, puts all our enemies in our place, and smite anybody who gets in our way, and let us rule with power. But that's not what happened. There's another viewpoint, and I was thinking about it, you know, from a children's viewpoint, since this is very much focused on children. What would I be thinking as a child? And that's very hard to do because I never do. Actually, I do it too much, actually. But, you know, he's riding on a donkey's colt, and I think that they're very stubborn animals. Now, I know humans aren't stubborn like that in any shape or form, and none of us have ever seen a child that was stubborn in any way whatsoever. So please just use your imagination and pretend. What if that donkey wanted to go in a different direction and it didn't want to go to Jerusalem? What if it wanted to go swimming? I don't think it wanted to go swimming though, but it probably wanted to raid some garden that had some fresh vegetables. Or maybe it didn't want to do anything, it just wanted to stay in the pasture and swish flies. But we have to ask ourselves, so far, where do we fit in? Are we looking for the wrong kind of God? Or are there other things that we would prefer to do than have Jesus be upon our shoulder? Or us be on his shoulders? What are we willing to leave in order to do the will of God? What gets in our way? What are the things that go through our minds? Is there a stubbornness within our own self that keeps us from doing all that God could use us for? With all the gifts and talents that we have, what are the things that we say no to? And what are the things that we say yes for? Because after all, at this time, neither of them could figure out how it would be to their advantage and how it would make things more easier for them. The scribes were worried sick. They didn't want the people to follow Jesus because it would interfere. fear in their life and how they knew it. Some of them were religious leaders. Some of them had memorized the scriptures backwards and forwards. They followed all kinds of different regulations and customs that helped them focus on God, but not focusing on the most important parts about who He is. The children, they would have never been out there and cheered and yelled Hosanna, proclaim anything about Him, if they had not been surrounded by believers that were able to instill in them the ability, at least at their level, to know that something very wonderful and very special was going on. They would have probably preferred otherwise to stay somewhere else and play video games. Of course, they didn't have video games back then. They played with dinosaur eggshells, I think. We always have some kind of distraction. I say that because I remember in Danbury, the altar boys got a new hand gizmo thing, and they were just going crazy on it. And I said, what are you doing? And they said, oh, that's right, Father. When you were that age, our age, you still had dinosaur shells to play with. So I just thought I'd pass that on to you. You see, there's all kinds of different views and how to interpret the world around us in Christianity and Jesus Christ. But the Pharisees, they didn't want them following Jesus, and they said the whole world is going to follow Him if this keeps happening. Because the people that were there had witnessed an incredible miracle that Lazarus, who had died and been put in a grave for 4 days, was called out and was alive. And that's a good point and a good area for ourselves to visualize. Do we, and are we aware of anyone that we have deeply, deeply loved and cared about? And what would we be willing to do to be called out of the grave and to be able to once again walk among us? With this story, some of his sisters were a little upset that it took him 4 days to get there. That if he had got there sooner, maybe he would have not even died to begin with. And the story of Lazarus is very important because Christianity is not an escape. It is not something to latch on to, be able to ignore the reality of the world around us. Christianity embraces even though we don't want to. We have to embrace death. We have to, sooner or later, deal with grief and sorrow and pain and questions that we can't work out. And then we have to make choices in how we're going to deal with it. And there's all kinds of ways. But in the view that happened here with Lazarus, their view was to testify to anybody who would listen that they knew someone who was a friend of Lazarus who called him out of the grave. Forget that and let it pass away, the grief and the sorrow and the pain. Not immediately. The 4 days is to symbolize that it takes time to work through our problems properly. Do not take a sedation that removes us from Jesus Christ and our tears and our grief and our sorrow. Many people pull away from the Lord. And you meet them 3 or 4 years later and they're still grieving in such a way that they have not regained their life back. that it takes courage and strength to walk forward. And no one could know this better than Jesus. Then we come to the Romans. They didn't care what these people were doing. They thought they were superstitious, and why in the world did they get worked up all about this stuff? And we live in a culture where there are the Romans who absolutely have no interest in Christianity and never take or lose a chance to ridicule. There's only one group still left in the United States that you can speak ill of all the time, every day, in the papers, on the radio, on the TV, on the newscasts, and that's Catholics. We are still persecuted and still drawn in the worst possible light. And now we get back to why we're here. We have to take every type of view that we have, and each one has their own view that they're struggling with, their own wounds and their own pain, their different reasons for what they're doing and what they're not doing, a burden that sometimes seems overwhelming. That is what Jesus is doing. You know, he could have directed that little donkey to do anything he wanted, you know. They couldn't get to Hawaii on him, but still. He went into Jerusalem knowing very well what was going to happen. All the cheering, everything that's going on. But what is his view right now? Living in the moment, not thinking ahead, not thinking behind, but looking right now. His view is seeing me and seeing you. Jesus is viewing my life. He's viewing humanity, and he's feeling everything you're feeling right now. Because he is also human, he can feel, and because he is divine, he can feel all of us. And he still wrote in. He can see my hurt, my fears, my insecurities, my disappointments, all those different things that tell us over and over and over again that we need this King. We need this Jesus. We need this Redeemer. And certainly all those different viewpoints will constantly keep tugging on us, trying to be the ones that we make our decisions for. But faith is the decision to be there, to cheer each other on, to sing Hosanna, not just for our own sake, for the other. Our gifts, our views, our abilities all help each other come closer to Jesus so that we can deal with all of these other views that are painful and hurtful and stubborn. He's coming in with view of knowing and everything and seeing everything. And his answer to all of that is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. I love you, and it's all worth it. If you have a pamphlet at this time, we will bless the palms, and then followed by procession.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, stretch forth your right hand and bless these branches here prepared for your people for the sake of your holy name. We call out to you in prayer, Lord, hear us.
O Lord of heavenly powers, the seraphim and cherubim, the angels and archangels and all spiritual beings tremble before you. They cover their eyes before your majesty's feet. They worship you with reverence and awe, and glorify you without ceasing. Here on earth you are praised by infants, children, all the faithful, with shouts of Hosanna. We implore you, O Lord, to pardon our faults in your grace, and to forgive our offenses in your mercy. May we live according to your will, and find mercy and compassion in this world and in the next. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Now let us bow our heads before the Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord God, you have shown us your plan of salvation. Now in your abundant mercy, bless these branches, that they may bless those who carry them and take them. May they educate children, strengthen the young, and give dignity to the elderly. May churches, monasteries, convents, and homes be filled with their blessings. May they confirm the faithful in the true faith, and in good works, glory, honor, and adoration are due to you, to your Father, and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
May these branches be blessed and sanctified in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Lord God, make us worthy to meet you in this procession on this solemn feast. Remove from us the weights of sin, and clothe us with robes of virtue. Purify our hands that we may carry candles and branches, leading us to holiness. Open our mouths that we may sing hymns and songs. Lead us on the path to chastity and angelic purity. In this holy procession, in all the days of our lives, we may praise you and glorify you, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
We'll slowly walk around once and then down through the center.
Jesus.
Christ our God, yesterday you revealed your divine nature by raising your friend Lazarus 4 days after he died. Today you reveal your human nature by humbly entering Jerusalem on a donkey's colt, accepting the praises of infants and children. Bless all the faithful who celebrate this holy feast. Purify their hearts and spirits, freeing them from jealousy, hypocrisy, hate, doubt, and all that is sinful. May we be innocent like the children who praise you on this day, and may we conclude this feast with heavenly joy and receive the blessings of these branches. O Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Deliver us from the trials of temptation that we do not have the strength to overcome. Confirm us in the true faith, fill us with love for you, for each other, and ground us in hope by your divine blood, which you have shed for our salvation. By your grace, and through the intercession of your holy and blessed mother, guard and protect all Christians who celebrate this feast. Have mercy on the faithful departed, who have gone to the rest, hoping in you, and may they dwell in your heavenly kingdom, rejoicing with you forever. Amen. You may be seated for the collection.
Through the abundance of your goodness, I will have you.
Lord and God, you accept the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children brought to you out of love, their love for you in your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and in place of their earthly gifts, grant them life in your kingdom.
Amen.
As we remember our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ and his plan of salvation for us, we recall upon this offering all those who please God from Adam to this day. Especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, St. Mary, St. Joseph, and St. Jude. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers, and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom this sacrifice is offered, for Teresa and for Jeanette. Remember also those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
Thank you. God of the Holy Spirit, be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our thoughts, our minds, and our hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord with reverence and worship Him with humility.
It is right and just.
With heart, mind, and heart, we give you thanks, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one to God. Join spiritually to the invisible choirs and countless ranks of angels. Your faithful people glorify you with them and three times proclaim the doom.
Hear us, O Lord.
Our Lord. Let us stand with your God and Father,
as we
and who is substantially the same as your Son. Ave Maria.
Oh, Father of mercies, and implore you, pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever. Amen.
O Lord, hasten to transform all that is harmful and detrimental into that which will help and benefit us, that we may bring glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads before the God of mercy, before his forgiving altar, and before the body and blood of our Savior, who gives life to those who partake of him, and receive the blessing of the Lord.
O Lord, may your graces, your blessings, and all your divine gifts be set in abundance on your church, your parishes, monasteries, and convents, that we may raise glory to you now and forever.
Amen.
The grace of the Most Holy Trinity, eternal and constant, shall be with you, my brothers and sisters, forever.
And with your spirit.
Let each one of us look to God with reverence and humility and ask him for mercy and compassion.
Holy gifts for the holy, with perfection, purity, and sanctity.
One Holy Father, one Holy Son, one Holy Spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord, for he is one in heaven and on earth. To him be glory forever. Make us worthy, O Lord our God, so that our bodies be sanctified by your holy love, and our souls purified by your forgiving love. May our communion be for the forgiveness of our sins and for your blood. O Lord our God, to you be glory forever.
Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life. Body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, forgiveness of sins and eternal life.
Thank you.
Holy Week. God bless you and keep you. Make sure you take a bulletin home with you. Yes, the schedule for Holy Week. Monday at noon, Tuesday at noon, Wednesday at noon, Thursday at 7, Friday at 11. It's going to be 11. The bulletin says 12, but it's really going to be at 11 Friday for the sign of the chalice. It's also in the paper that way. And the burial service, Friday night at 7 p.m. Saturday, the vigil will be at 7. There you go. I got it out there. And of course, Easter Sunday will be at 10. So that is great and good. Thank you for all the well wishes for my anniversary, for being ordained, in my first liturgy. I used my ordination chalice to celebrate the liturgy, the cross, the vestment. The vestment shrunk a little tiny bit. And I wore my anniversary ring also. It's got 9 little tiny diamonds, 9 kids. I'm the middle one in there, middle child, you can probably tell. But anyway, I wish you a happy Hosanna Sunday. It is a happy day. We do have Jesus Christ, our King, who is glorious in majesty in every way. I hope to see you during Holy Week, and I think there's some little treats for the children downstairs when we process out after the closing hymn. Heavenly Father, we glorify you and praise you, we worship you, and give you all the thanks, O Lord, to watch over the children of our parish, that you may guide them and strengthen them in the faith, to be able to the rest of their life be able to sing Hosanna in the highest, now and forever. Amen. Please stand for the blessing. God peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and blessings you have received from the forgiving of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most Holy Trinity come to you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, the one God, to whom be glory forever. Amen. I leave you in peace, O Lord. Blessed be upon those who pray for vocations. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary to you.
With you.